The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
What comparison can I find for this generation? It is like children shouting to each other as they sit in the marketplace. We played the pipes for you, and you would not dance. We sang dirges, and you wouldn't be mourners. For John came, neither eating nor drinking, and they say he is possessed. The Son of Man came, eating and drinking, and they say, look, a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners. Yet wisdom is justified by her deeds. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers, every time we listen to the word of God, we are called to conversion. The word of God must pierce our hearts. The revelation must cause in our hearts a revolution, and then that should end up in a personal resolution for each of us to be better. In today's first reading, for example, Isaiah telling the people of their lack of commitment, especially of their lack of openness to listen to the word of God. And he says, all your sufferings, maybe because of your infidelity, because of your disobedience. And look at these words 17 and 18. That is given there. I am Yahweh your God and teach you for your own good. I lead you in the way you ought to go. The word of God always leads us in the way we ought to go. That's why constant reading of the Bible, listening to the Bible, meditating on the Bible, we do not know the way we ought to go. And then this particular sentence, if only you had listened to my commandments. The prophet is telling them, you did not listen to the commandments. Your exile in Babylon is all result of you are not listening to the commandments. The Lord wanted to teach you a lesson. These words must echo in our hearts, especially during this season. If only you had listened to the superiors to follow the rules of the seminary. If only you had listened to the conferences. If only you had followed the instructions given to you. If only you had listened to the expectations of your parents and teachers. See how these words should strike us today. If only you had listened to your commandments. Could have been better. Could have accomplished better. Could have had greater joy. Joy according to the heart of the Lord. So these words are really very striking. If only you had listened to your commandments, then Isaiah describes what all would have happened instead of the exile. Your prosperity would have been like a river, and your saving justice like the waves of the sea. You did not prosper enough. You did not accomplish enough. You did not cause much joy in the community. All because you did not listen. Your prosperity would have been like a river, and your saving justice like the waves of the sea. Your descendants would have been numbered like the sand. Your offspring as many as its grains. Think of the promise given to Abraham. Like the grains of the sand on the shore of the sea. Their name would never be cancelled or blotted out from my presence. Beautiful passage for us to know that we need to constantly listen to the word of God, listen to the instructions, and be obedient to the Lord. Obedience means prosperity. Obedience means abundance. Obedience means no need to regret in our life. And then we come to today's gospel, all compared to children in the marketplace, uncooperative children, disgruntled children, children who are irritable to the invitation to the conversion. Jesus invited the people to be converted. John the Baptist invited the people to be converted. But all the time they found mistakes. Jesus gives a beautiful parable. As we know that we also as children played so many games. Those children those days played also such games. Wedding games, funeral games. Some children want to play wedding games, playing flute. Other children are uncooperative. They don't dance. Another group of children want to play funeral games. They are again uncooperative to that group. We played the pipes for you, you would not dance. We sang dirges, you would not be mourners. The second group also don't want to cooperate. Jesus says, you are all going on giving excuses. What is important is that you follow the way of the Lord by listening to the preaching of the prophets. Whether it is John the Baptist or me, we came at two different levels with the two different types of life and invitation to be converted. But you found fault with John the Baptist, you are finding fault with me. Sometimes also it may happen in our lives also. Some people will go on giving excuses. As I say, constantly grumbling. This is not right, that's why I did like this. Exactly like the people of Jesus' time. John came neither eating nor drinking, and they say he is possessed. Instead of listening to John's invitation to conversion, they are accusing John he is possessed because he is not eating, he is not drinking. He is very simple. He is not acceptable to us. And the Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, look, a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of the tax collectors and sinners. The invitation to conversion is there, constantly addressed to us through the word of God, through the superiors, through the elders, through the exemplary life of others. Are we going to be converted and experience a real joy as Jesus wants us to have? That is the big question today. Let us make the maximum of our life. Let us not give excuses. Let us not be uncooperative with the invitation of the Lord for us. May the grace of this Eucharist make us resolve to be more faithful, more alive, more fruitful. Amen.